just about set to kick off. This coin toss presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. We're ready to get this one underway as the teams are lined up for the opening kick. He sends this one deep. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
Texas State's offense, a lot of times they can spread things out and they can really be versatile offensively. But when you got a wide receiver like this, it really helps the cause.
It does, and it continues to help with what they're trying to do. They're trying to find matchups. And when you have one player like this that the defense has got to be aware of, they're going to spread you out, try to find a one-on-one matchup. And if you spend too much time with this one player, they've got some other weapons to make you pay for it.
Zips it to the back. Tackle at the 39.
I like the call here by the defense to bring the heat with the outside linebacker. It was just a better call by the offense, and that's why it's a first down.
He has some room. Makes it out to about the 50. The middle for a nice game. Big opening. Runs it right. Nice pickup. Gets out to around the 28.
Gain of 8 on the play. That makes it second and 2.
So it's second down and about 2 yards to go.
Let's make these babies cry all the way back home.
He's at the 20. Tackle made at about the 11. Another carry for this kid, and he'll get the first down.
He's carrying this offense on his back right now, and I think they'll keep giving him the ball until the defense figures out a way to stop him.
Takes it up the middle for a nice run. And the defense just swarmed over him on that one.
Yeah, they were able to penetrate the offensive line and get to the running back before that play even had a chance.
Throws to the receiver, got it for the touchdown. Catch by the receiver for the touchdown.
Anytime you're near the red zone, you got to keep an eye for this guy. They love going to him down here.
You know, if a quarterback has a strong arm, one of his favorite routes is the post. But I thought the quarterback did a really good job here of using his eyes to move the safety, to open up that void in the defense, and then he made the good throw to the receiver for the touchdown.
After review of the play, the ruling on the field stands.
So the call on the field stands. He makes the PAT. A nice 10-play, 73-yard drive, and a touchdown as a result.
Brad, that's one of those drives that can just tear your heart out. They can really demoralize a defense when they drive the ball down the field, and a lot of the yards came on the ground.
So let's see what the offense can do as they come out onto the field. He makes it out to maybe the 43-yard line. And the halfback carries for a pickup of 3.
That makes it 7-6.
Hey, kill, kill!
46-yard line. Superb effort by the receiver to come down with that ball.
Now this comes down to the timing between the quarterback and the receiver, and the result, again, a nice play for the offense.
And he's taken down right around the 44-yard line. Down to the 36. Here's a screen pass. Gets it to the back. He's taken down at the 40-yard line. He made the catch, but he didn't get the first down.
Yeah, right now, the way this defense is swarming, there's just no room for him to get upfield for the first down.
The catch and gets out of bounds.
Good job here by the receiver to look the ball in and ensure he had possession. That's the right way to catch a pass.
Fires out to his receiver. They just took what the defense gave them on that play.
Yeah, you're right. That was a good job of getting that pass completed for positive yardage.
Brought down after a nice run up the middle. The stop around the 14-yard line. Throws complete. He's got room to work. He's tackled at the one. He's hit and taken down. From the 1 yard line, second down.
Kid is a really reliable weapon. You definitely want the football in his hands near the end zone, and he showed you why right there.
Perfect job there of spreading out that defense and then going to the ground game. And he adds the extra point. It was a 13-play, 78-yard drive, and they put up 7 points. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
I think we saw the effects of what a long drive can do to a defense the last time this offense was out on the field. They took that football and drove the length of the field to put points up on the board. I think it really started to affect not only just the psyche of this defense, but maybe even the conditioning where they started to get a little bit fatigued.
Rid of this one. Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 46. Hey, Mike.
makes the catch, and the defense is all over him. They bring him down for a loss. A one-yard loss.
Really, they just had nowhere to go after the catch.
Back to the action here in the second quarter. It's been a good one and a tight one at this point. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. This is the point in the game where you don't want to make any mistakes that give the other guys a reason to feel more confident going into halftime. They'll go ground. He makes it out to maybe the 20-yard line. Makes his way to about the 28. Gets out to about the 31. Two-yard line. Stays in bounds to make a nice catch. It out to maybe the 49-yard line.
Call it a gain of 3 yards. That makes it second and eight.
Second down, 8 yards to go. Ball on the 49-yard line. Nice run there. It's complete, and he's tackled around the 25-yard line. He makes it to the 25-yard line. At about the 23-yard line.
That makes it 7-8.
And he's tackled after positive yardage. We got a flag down on the field. Might have been offside. They got across the line a bit too soon.
Give the quarterback some credit here for using his cadence to draw the defense off sides.
Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. He makes it out to maybe the 16-yard line. A 2-yard run by the halfback. And he throws it away. It's fourth down, and they're going to try to go for it. Possession on down.
You know, that was one of those situations where you have to go for it to try to get something going. Now they need a big play here from their defense.
Really a great stop by the defense. This will go down as one of those critical plays. They've been like a couple of fighters feeling each other out so far. Let's see if they start to open it up a little bit more now. Caught it, but they're going to lose yards. He was tackled immediately. Taken back a yard.
Pretty good stand there. They weren't fooled at all by the offensive play call.
So it's second and 10. Ball on the 15. Wants to go long and does. Drops it. Oklahoma's going to take their first time out of the half. Gets to about the 44-yard line. I give the defense credit, but right now I think it's more a case of sloppy offense.
Yeah, you got to recognize that both defenses have come into this game with the right mindset. They're very well prepared. But I'm with you. It's one thing to have great defense. It's another thing when those defenses are going up against offenses that just are not clicking right now and hitting on all cylinders.
From the 44-yard line, second down. He's got it with room to run. Down in the open field. What a throw for a big game.
That is a great example of the quarterback seeing the whole field and finding the guy who had the best chance of making a catch.
And he makes it out to about the 34-yard line. It's fourth down, and the offense is getting set to go for it. Trying to get a head start there.
False start.
Just a mental lapse, but it's going to cost him 5 yards.
Still fourth down.
Tackle made at about the 31. His receiver, first down, and down he goes around the 15-yard line. Under heavy pressure, and he's going to be sacked.
Man, as an offensive lineman, this is the worst thing that you want to see. Your quarterback not only getting sacked, but getting hit like that. Those linemen better pick that quarterback up and start doing a better job of taking care of him.
Fires out quickly to the tailback. They'll bring him down at about the 13. We've played a half. We're even at 7 in this one.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Davis, David Pollack here in the studio, as always, to lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes. Perhaps the most important statistic in any football game is turnover margin. I once had a wise coach tell me that the football was so important they named the game after it. Whatever that means. I think it means that you're not supposed to let it get away from you and give it to the other team. And so far, both of these offenses have done a great job of that.
No doubt. And most games are lost, not won. And it's because of the turnover differential. You can look at the stats when you say that every single time. But, you know, both teams doing a good job taking care of it. Both offenses executing and still calling a game, still scoring points, still putting up good numbers, but at the same time taking care of the pigskin. And they better value that thing because, yeah, you give it away and bad things happen.
I can only hope that Nestler and Herb Street will bring the same type of intensity to their call of the second half that David and I have brought to the halftime show. Of course, they always do. That's it for us here in the studio. Time to get you back out to the guys for the second half.
And we welcome you back to the action here, just about set for the second half.
Nice kick, plenty of distance. He's to the 20. And down he goes at the 22.
A lot of times you'll see teams start to clinch up a little bit when games stay close well into the second half. You need to stay loose, keep doing what you've been doing all week in practice, and execute when it's time. Incomplete, trying to get it to his receiver.
Now the quarterback has to be careful here not to leave his receiver so vulnerable like that. He took a licking right there.
From their own 22-yard line. Second down. Halfback's got it on the quick throw. And he's taken down around the 24-yard line. Slings it. He's taken down at the 33. That makes it first and 10. He gets out to about the 35-yard line. Stop around the 44-yard line. First and 10. Ball on the 44-yard line. He's tackled around the 30-yard line. With a quick throw. The defender had his hands on it, but it's incomplete.
Well, the offense catches a break here. That ball should have been intercepted there by the safety, so the quarterback gets the ball back here for this next down.
We're at play number 9 of this current drive. And a quick throw. He's pushed out of bounds at the 27. That's a gain of 3 on the play. That'll bring up 36. Looks middle, got his back. Brought down around the 26-yard line. It's fourth down. They'll call on the field goal unit here for this long field goal attempt. Oklahoma could take the lead with this field goal. It has the distance, and it's good. And he's got to be happy about that kick.
Oh, no question. This kid is just a solid kicker.
10-7, Oklahoma. Excellent kick. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. The Sooners continue to get it done on the defensive side of the football, Kirk.
Yeah, they've done a good job of building this lead and almost determined here to protect it. Let's see if they can hold on here for the rest of the way.
There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. He's to the 40. He's at midfield. Inside the 30, the 10, touchdown Bobcats.
I can guarantee you'll be seeing that one in the highlight reels. What a great, great run. A real display of all the tools that he brings to the table.
And the good news for this offense is they took the lead back. But the bad news is that the other offense is more than capable of putting points up on the board as well.
Tacks on the extra point. Texas State kicked this one off. And he got all of this one. Great kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
Both teams have really answered the bell here in the third quarter, Kirk.
Well, exciting to see what these offenses have been able to do here. Be able to come out and score in your first drive tells you a lot about what they did during the half.
This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. Catches it, and he's immediately tackled behind the line. That's a loss of about three.
Not much going on there. Those kind of plays will not work against this defense. You can be sure of that.
Second and 13 coming up here. Ball on the 22-yard line.
Here we go, here we go, here we go.
They get to the quarterback and end that play before it even got started.
This young man didn't even have a chance to make something happen. It's tough to find your receivers when the defense is in your face like that.
The sack makes this a fourth and very long. Taken down at the 37-yard line.
Well, this is a very competitive game. Just when you think one team has gained the advantage or the momentum, the other team comes fighting back, and it's going back and forth. This is almost like a basketball game.
And we see this offense again after what you, Kirk, called a very physical touchdown drive.
Well, I say that, Brad, because the big hog mollies up front were able to create holes for the running game, and it helped them get the score. Let's see if they can do it again.
Texas State is up by four. Runs it and tackled in the backfield. Third down, and they need to get it to the 27. He's in trouble. He guns it left side. Great concentration to pull it in. And he's tackled in the open field.
What a huge letdown by the defense on a big third down play. And that is just inexcusable.
Touchdown.
Well, the question now is, how will they respond after losing a couple on that run?
It's second and goal. Ball on the 11-yard line. Touchdown, Bobcats. Play.
The defense is so concerned about the quarterback's ability to create that they left a halfback all alone. And once he took the pitch, there wasn't anything between him and the goal line.
He makes the PAT. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He sends this one deep. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. Up the middle for a nice game. Fights forward to about the 33. Big opening. Makes it out to about the 43. It right, he can't get back to the line. A quarter to go, and can they pull the upset? The Bobcats in front by 11. Into the fourth quarter now, and we're back to the action. They come out in a 5-wide set. Quickly. They pick up a good 6 yards there.
Well, he really didn't have to do too much there to give himself a little room to make the catch.
So an empty backfield with 5 wide receivers. And he's leveled at the 41-yard line. They've got 10 guys up. It looks like they're going to try to block this one. And he has it on the corner. Fielded at the 19. And he's taken down at the 26-yard line. Both teams are well aware that a score on this drive is going to create an almost insurmountable lead. This defense has really got to step it up and make a stop. Tackled around the 27-yard line. The offense didn't get the playoff in time.
Delayed game, offense.
You got to be careful to avoid these. Penalties are a great way to stall out a drive.
Two times.
So it's second and 14. Ball on their own 22. makes the grab and steps out right away. That one goes for good yardage and a first down.
Yeah, that's just a nice gain on second down.
Keeps it on the option and picks up maybe four. That makes it second and six. From their own 41-yard line, it's second down. Just under three to go in regulation. Takes it up the middle for a nice run. Oklahoma's going to take their first time out of the half. Second down and five. Ball on the 47-yard line. And he is drilled at the 44-yard line. The back gets three on the carry.
That was a great tackle. The defender seemingly came out of nowhere and put a big hit on the ball carrier.
And they get nice yardage on that one.
What is going on with this defense? I mean, don't get me wrong. The offense is doing a nice job with first downs and executing well, but the defense is just letting them maintain possession and move the ball right down the field. They've got to try to change things up with their scheme. Be more aggressive. Attack. Do some things to change it up. Take some risks.
They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. This is the 10th play of this drive. We should just see the quarterback take a knee right here, winding down the rest of this clock. He'll go down to one knee. From the 27-yard line, second down. You're an offensive coordinator. You love this play. His quarterback will take a knee. The Bobcats coaching staff, Kirk, do they start wondering, hey, are we going to have trouble with our star player after the struggles he had today?
Well, I think the coaching staff's got to be happy that this team was able to win the football game and overcome the fact that their star player didn't have a great game. But I think making adjustments and changing the game plan because their star didn't deliver, I think that would be a big mistake.
That does it for this edition of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler saying so long.